Number 39 Quebec, contact Long Beach Tower 119.4, advise them of your intentions. Good day.
Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics. This can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck.
Long Beach Tower Center, Airport 6, turn out Quebec's inbound on the RNAV Zulu.
Long Beach, also known as Daugherty Field, is a busy, medium-sized, multi-use airport located in the city of Long Beach, California. Situated 15 miles southeast of the larger, more congested Los Angeles International Airport, it is a convenient alternative. There are no less than five more airports of varying sizes within a 10-mile radius of Long Beach. Its associated Class Delta airspace is adjacent to Los Alamitos Army Airfield's airspace and underlies the Los Angeles Class Bravo. The airport layout consists of a set of parallel runways with staggered thresholds. These are 8 left and right and 2-6 left and right. The largest runway, Runway 12 and 30, intersects Runway 8 left, 26 right. The complex taxiway system provides access to all areas. First-time visitors should note that all general aviation services are located on the southwest side of the airport. Southern California is known for its high volume of air traffic, both civil and military. This, coupled with complex airspace requirements and numerous surrounding airports, makes Long Beach an interesting and challenging place to work and fly. The traffic at Long Beach includes the spectrum of aviation. Everything from primary civil training aircraft utilized by multiple flight schools up through large military transports, all frequent the airport. Pilots are reminded to use caution for possible jet blast or wake turbulence at all times. Banner tow operations are authorized at Long Beach Airport. Banner pickup and drop locations are located in between the parallel runways. Additionally, numerous helicopter operations and scheduled air carrier operations round out the diverse traffic picture. Pilots, please note that helicopters inbound to the field from the north and south enter the traffic pattern between the parallel runways by crossing either runway 26 left or 26 right, midfield, at 500 feet to join a downwind leg or to enter a holding point east of the terminal building or west of runway 12 and 30 over the large hangar. As with any airport with parallel runways with staggered thresholds, the risk of wrong surface landings exists at this airport. This risk is compounded in the late afternoon prior to sunset when landing on runways 26 left and right. The position of the sun can make it difficult to see the runways. When arriving at any airport, it is important to listen to the Automatic Terminal Information System, the ATIS, before entering the airport vicinity. This is particularly important in Long Beach due to the use of two tower frequencies based on traffic volume and staffing. Specific pattern entry information is in the chart supplement. Detailed instructions about pattern entry and altitude limits need to be thoroughly understood and complied with when arriving at Long Beach. These instructions rely on pilots being able to locate the Signal Hill VFR reporting point. If you are unable to locate this point, advise the tower. They will provide alternate instructions. Signal Hill is just one of many commonly used inbound reporting points for Long Beach Airport. Pilots should become familiar with these reporting points and their locations prior to flying to Long Beach. Under certain conditions, Long Beach runs simultaneous intersecting runway operations to runway 30 and runway 26 right by using land and hold short, or LAHSO, procedures. The tower will inform pilots of their sequence to the runway and of traffic landing the intersecting runway. Pilots, be sure to read back the runway hold short instruction, as the tower must ensure you have read it back correctly. After landing, When clearing the runway, be sure you taxi completely across the hold short lines for the runway behind you. You are not clear of the runway until your entire aircraft is across this line. Small aircraft landing on runway 30 should plan to expeditiously exit the runway at Delta 4 or Lima 4 if possible, or at the earliest available exit, as larger aircraft are often close in trail. When clear, calling ground control as soon as practical with call sign, location, and intentions will help ATC get you where you want to go expeditiously. Hotspot 1 concerns aircraft cleared from the West Ramp. The West Ramp, Taxiway Juliet, and Taxiway Juliet 4 are in close proximity to runway 8 right, 26 left. If you are outbound from this location, do not exit the ramp to the south through the green island directly on to Taxiway Juliet 4. Be sure to make the turn onto Taxiway Juliet to avoid entering the runway inadvertently. As stated earlier, the taxiway system at the airport is complex. For this reason, ground control will sometimes issue progressive taxi instructions. If you are unsure or in doubt of any instruction or clearance, the best answer is to ask the tower. They are there to help. When departing Long Beach, contact clearance delivery and provide call sign, type aircraft, current ATIS, and runway requested for departure prior to contacting ground control. If desired, you can request flight following services with clearance or ground. There are designated run-up areas on the way to each runway. Once the run-up is complete, pilots must contact ground control for clearance to continue to taxi. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Long Beach will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the air traffic control tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Long Beach Daugherty Field Airport. It's always better to know before you go.